Hello and welcome back to our course, Building Cost Estimation Simplified. In today's video lesson, we will be learning about the basic estimation procedure. We will now look at the learning objective. The learning objective of this video lesson is the introduction to the method and procedure to prepare estimation for simple projects using schedule of rates engineering data. First, we look at the concept of standard schedule of rates. So, how do we find the rates of materials and tasks? We know that during estimation, first we do the quantification of the work, and also the next step is to find the expected estimated cost. For this, we apply the rates to the material and tasks, the quantity of material and tasks, and then we multiply them and then we get the final value. The rates of various works vary according to geographical area and other factors. So when it comes to rates, the schedule of rates is an important document for estimators. The schedule of rates is a document published usually by the government which has the rates of material and labor. So it has got different rates for unskilled labor, semi-skilled labor, skilled labor, rates of materials and also conveyance rates, and these are published in the document. These rates can be directly adopted by the estimator and then applied on the quantity of material that the estimator arrives at for his or her own project. Now, the schedule of rates has got different rates for different activities. So it could have the wages for unskilled labor per person per day. It could be 180, it is 180 rupees, and or it could have the wages for second class mason per person per day. It could also have the per cubic meter rate of earthwork excavation for trenches in loose soils, or it can also have the rate of per cubic meter of 40 mm granite stone, the rate of a material that is also available in the schedule of rates. For the purpose of our video lesson, we will be taking examples from the rural standard schedule of rates. Now, this is an example of a schedule of rates, a page from the schedule of rates. We see it has got the rate list of labor and materials. So after we quantify our work, as in we find the dimensions and then we find the final quantity of work that is to be done, or the material that is to be used. We use the rate list, the rates from the rate list, and then apply it to the quantity that we have arrived at. These are all approved standard rates, and as you can see on the screen, in the first column we have the codes, and then in the second column we have the description. And it is important to have a code, and while we estimate, while we do our estimation, it is important to carry on this code into our estimate so that there is no confusion, because sometimes descriptions can be deceptively similar and it could cause confusion and also errors. So it's always good to have the code carried over to our estimate. Then in the next column, we have the units of measurement in cubic meters and as the case may be. Then the rates we have in the final column. We move on to the next slide. Let's look at the steps in preparing an estimate. When we prepare an estimate, it is an assessment for the future. And when we estimate the time that is required for completion of work, and also what are the resources required, like manpower, etc., and what is the fund to be allocated for that particular project. And even though estimation is an approximation for future, a variation within the range of plus or minus 10% of the estimated amount is important to make the estimate relevant, because even though we are predicting for the future based on the information available now or from the past experience, for an estimate to be effective, it has to be within the range of plus or minus 10% from what we estimate, the estimated value. So it could be maybe 10% more or 10% less, only then it becomes efficient, or it becomes relevant for us. And we will now look at some of the terminologies that will help us understand estimation process better. One is the detailed estimate, one is abstract estimate, and detailed cum abstract estimate. We will look at these concepts in detail in the next few slides. So first of all, we are looking at the detailed estimate. Now, in a detailed estimate, dimensions and quantities are recorded. So we have a format on the screen. We have a column for serial number. Then we have a column for description of task. So here we describe what the task is, whether it is excavation, whether it is brickwork, whatever it is, we write what the task is. Then we have the unit of measurement. We have seen that unit of measurement is very integral. We have to mention it whenever we mention a task. Only then it makes sense, because whether it is square meter or cubic meters or whatever is the unit of measurement, we have to mention that clearly in our estimate. Now the number is to represents the number of times that activity is done, or the quantity that is in the basically, if it is trench work, if we are doing one trench work or two, we have to mention the number here. Now we have three other columns which are corresponding to length, width and depth, and then we have a column for quantity, and we find the quantity by multiplying the length, width and depth. For example, if you are looking at the size of a trench, the length, breadth and height of the trench that is to be excavated, those are entered into the detailed estimate. Now, abstract estimate. Based on the detailed estimate, we can arrive at the abstract estimate. So here we have the quantities, rates and amounts. If you recall, in the previous one, we had the quantities with individual dimensions like length, breadth and height. And then when we come to abstract estimate, we have additional information available. In this, we retain the quantity and unit of measure as taken from the detailed estimate. So we have a serial number, description of task as in the previous one, the unit of measurement, and also we take the quantity which we got from the detailed estimate. And then what we add here is that we include the unit rate of each work, and then we multiply this unit rate with the quantity, and then we get the final amount. So it is here that the schedule of rates comes handy, because we take the rates from the schedule of rates document. We must note that in an abstract estimate, the individual dimensions are not given. Instead, we have the direct quantities taken and represented here. Now we move on to the detailed cum abstract estimate. Now this is a combination of both the detailed estimate and abstract estimate. Here we put all the information from the detailed estimate and abstract estimate, and when we put them together. So we have the serial number, description of task, unit of measurement, length, width, depth, and the quantity, which is the quantity is arrived at by multiplying all the three. And then we have the rate and we have the amount. And we saw in our previous two slides that these were separate in the case of detailed estimate and abstract estimate. But over here, we have them all combined together. This is an example of a detailed cum abstract estimate. As you can see on the screen, we have the serial number, description of task, unit of measurement, unit of work, which is either cubic meters, meter square, meter or number, the number, length in meters, width in meters, depth or thickness in meters, the quantity in cubic meters or meter square, rate in rupees and amount in rupees. So the activity is earthwork excavation for trench in ordinary soils and depositing on a trench bank with an initial lead of 10 meters and depth up to 1 meter, including all operational, incidental, labor charges such as breaking clouds, trimming to slopes, etc., complete for finished item of work as per SS 20B in ordinary soils. So we have the description of the task, that is trench cutting. The unit of measurement is cubic meters. The activity, as in how many times we are doing, it's just one. We have the length, and then we have the width, and we have the depth. So those are recorded here. and the quantity would be the multiplication of the length, width and depth. And so we have 6 into 3 into 0.5, which is 9. And now we have, it's 9 meter cube. And now we have the rate, which is 100. This is taken from the schedule of rates. And then what is the final amount? We find it as the multiplication of a product of quantity into rate, which is 900. So this is an example of a detailed cum abstract estimate. The resources that we need to prepare an estimate, we look into what are the broad steps for preparing an estimate. See, we know that for an estimate, we require the BOQ, the bill of quantity, which is how much the quantity of material that we are going to use in that project. It could be quantity of cement, it could be quantity of brick, it could be quantity of wood, or it could be quantity of the plywood, anything. So what is the quantity of material that is used? And this is something that we record in our bill of quantities. Now, what are the rates of material and labor? Which we can find from the schedule of rates. We also would need the drawings. The drawings give us an idea of, communicate to us what the project is about. Then we need the specification about what are the details of how to build, what are the quality aspects to be taken into consideration. And then we also need the detailed measurements. So when we look at it in a stepwise manner, we need to mention the description of the work and its scope. We need to give the details about the name of work, the location, the purpose, etc. Now, next we need to record the dimensions of the work. In this, we record the length, breadth, and height of each task in order to arrive at the quantities. Now, the design and drawings. Drawings are very important components of an estimate. The design is the basis on which the structure is built, and this gives the understanding of the stability of the structure. And drawings are an integral part of the construction of a building, because the drawing tells us how to build the structure, build the project. And the design usually includes identification and finalization of construction material and dimension, and it also communicates to us about the stability of the work or structure that is to be constructed. So design and drawings are an integral part of the estimate, the estimator would need, the person who is estimating would need the design and drawings to be able to do the estimation. Now, specification of works and tasks. We saw that the drawings and the design communicates a lot of information to the estimator, but the specifications provide more detailed information. It gives the detailed aspects like dimensions, construction material used, construction technology to be used, and the quality of work that is needed for constructing that project. We also would need detailed quantities of the task. We put in the details of quantities, and this is put into the estimate in the format that is given for estimation. Now let's look at the calculation of material. How do we calculate material? So, let's take the example of concrete. We know that concrete is a mixture of fine and coarse aggregate along with cement and water. Now, mixed design, this is a process of determining the right quantity of materials to prepare concrete and their relative proportions to achieve desired properties like workability, strength, setting time, and durability. When we explain it, it means that we know that concrete is a mixture. Now, what is the ratio of the mixture? Because it has got different components. We saw that it has got fine and coarse aggregate, and there is cement, there is water also. Now, we cannot just arbitrarily mix cement, concrete, the cement and the various components of it. There are proportions. Each component has got a relative proportion to each other. And the final outcome that we are looking at is certain properties of concrete. Like, we need a certain workability, we need a certain strength, we need a setting time and durability. So this is very important when we use concrete on site, And so we would need some calculation, some understanding about how much quantity of material is required for preparing concrete. So we have a concept called theoretical consumption of material based on calculations using density and weight and volume, etc., of each material, and also by observation. Some unit requirements are fixed in advance. These are called theoretical consumption of material. So when there is a hand mixing done on a construction site, certain ratios are already prescribed and which can be followed for the work that is assigned on the site. Now, we must remember the grade of concrete is an important factor here to find out the quantity of cement. The grade of concrete depends upon the water-cement ratio. And the quantity of cement that is used is dependent on the water-cement ratio. And the quantity of cement also determines the other components like the sand, the coarse aggregate, the gravel that is to be used in the mix. So these are all interrelated. So in order to find we need to find the amount of cement that is used to arrive at the other components of a concrete mix. So we'll have a calculation example of theoretical consumption of material. So the example is that to prepare 1 cubic meter of concrete, so the final outcome is that we need a concrete block of 1 cubic meters. And the proportion is 1 is to 2 is to 4, which means the ratio of cement, sand and aggregate are to each other are in the ratio of cement being one portion, sand being two portions and aggregate being four portions. So the ratio of quantity of cement, sand and aggregate in 1 cubic meter of concrete is as follows. Cement is the cement that is used for this specification is 1.37 bags, where 1 bag of cement is 50 kgs. The sand is 0.43 cubic meters. Aggregate is 0.85 cubic meters. This is also where the specification becomes important. For example, the quantity required while preparing 1 is to 2 is to 4 concrete is not the same as what is needed for a cement concrete mixture of 1 is to 5 is to 10 ratio or 1 is to 4 is to 8. Now we look at some important factors, some important facts that will help us. Cement density is 1440 per kilogram per meter cube, which means that 1 cubic meter of cement weighs 1440 kgs. 1 bag of cement weighs 50 kilogram by weight. By volume, this is 0.036 meter cube. The number specified while mentioning mortar or concrete reflects the ratio of cement, sand and aggregate in the final mixture. So if we say 1 is to 2 is to 4, it implies that in the final mixture of the cement, concrete or mortar, the cement, sand, aggregate ratio is 1 is to 2 is to 4. We must remember that the volume of the mixture that we get after mixing all these components is always less than the total volume of all the materials mixed. This is because the final materials in the mixture of concrete will fill the space between the particles of the coarser materials. Now, how to estimate the cement quantity required in concrete mixes? The relationship between certain volumes of concrete required and material required is given below. So, on the left side column, we have the mixture by volume, and there's also mention of the maximum stone size. So, we have 1 is to 4 is to 8, 1 is to 3 is to 6, 1 is to 2 is to 4, and 1 is to 1.5 is to 3. The cement bags, 3.5 bags is 175 kilograms, 4.5 bags is 225 kilograms, 6.5 bags is 325 kilograms, 8.25 is 365 kilograms. So we have the relationships given for different specifications. If the mix is 1 is to 4 is to 8, the cement 3.5 cement bags are needed, which is about 175 kgs of cement. And the sand needed is 0.48 meter cube. And the stone needed is 0.96 meter cube. Similarly, for 1:1:3:6, it is 4.5 cement bags, which is about 225 kgs. Then 0.47 meter cube of sand and 0.94 stone. For 1:2:4, it is 6.5 cement bags, which is 325 kgs. And sand is 0.45 meter cube and stone is 0.9 meter cube. When we have a ratio of 1:1:5:3, we use about 8.25 bags of cement, which is about 365 kgs, and the sand is 0.43 meter cubes, and stone used is 0.85 meter cube. So the above table can help us calculate the quantities of stone aggregate, the cement, or sand that we need to make a mix of required ratio. Now we look at the estimation of quantity of materials in concrete. So here we have again table that we saw earlier. The example given is for 2 cubic meters of finished concrete work of 1:4:8 proportion, what is the amount of cement, sand and stone aggregate that is to be used? So from the table, we find that for 1 cubic meters of concrete mix of 1:4:8, we look at 1:4:8, that's the first row. We need about 3.5 bags of cement and we need 0.48 cubic meters of sand and 0.96 meter cube of stone respectively. This is for 1 cubic meter of finished concrete. Now when we want 2 cubic meters of cement concrete, it becomes a double of the quantity that is given in the table. So what we do is we just multiply these values by 2. So the cement required will become 3.5 bags into 2, which is about 7 bags, which is 350 kgs. And the sand required is for 2 cubic meters of finished concrete is double of 0.48, which is 0.96 cubic meters. And the stone aggregate required in 2 cubic meters of finished concrete is double of 0.96, which is 1.92 cubic meters. Now, to estimate the quantity required in mortar. So we have cement and sand in this because it's cement mortar. So here the mix is given as 1:6, 1:5, 1:4, 1:3 and 1:2. Again, the material required for 1 meter cube of finished mortar work by volume, that is the table represents that. So here we have 4.8 cement bags and 1 meter cube of sand for the specification 1:6. For 1:5 it is 5.75 and 1. For 1:4 it is 6.89 cement bags and 1 meter cube of sand. And for 1:3, the cement bags needed are 9.6 cement bags and 1 meter cube of sand. And for 1:2, it is 13.63 cement bags and 0.96 meter cube of sand. Now we look at bricks, how to estimate the bricks, cement and sand in brickwork. So 1 cubic meter of brickwork in cement, sand, mortar with bricks of standard size. So here we have given the mortar ratio. And so we have again cement and sand for the mortar and the brick numbers. Now what is the relation between all the three? So when the mortar ratio is 1:7, we need for 1 cement bag we need 0.25 cubic meters of sand and 500 bricks. For 1:5, it is 1.2 cement bags, 0.25 cubic meters of sand and 500 bricks. Similarly, for 1:6, it is 1.45 cement bags, 0.25 cubic meters of sand and 500 bricks. For 1:4, it's 1.75 cement bags, 0.25 meter cube of sand and 500 bricks. For 1:3, the cement bags are 2.4 cement bags, 0.25 meter cube of sand and 500 bricks. For 1:2, it is 3.45 cement bags, 0.24 sand and 500 bricks. Now we have an example of how to estimate the quantities of sand, cement and bricks in construction of a room which requires 2.5 cubic meters of brickwork. The standard brick size has been used with 1:4 proportion mortar is to be used. So we saw the previous table, from the t previous table, that what are the what is the relation between cement, the mortar and the brick numbers that are needed, and we see that for one, and this is for 1 cubic meters of brickwork in cement and mortar. So 1 cubic meter of construction brickwork would require 1.75 bags of cement, because we see that the mortar ratio is 1:4. So we'd see that 1.7 bags of cement is to be used. 0.25 is the meter cube is the sand that is to be used, the volume of sand to be used, the quantity of sand to be used, and the bricks, the brick numbers are 500. Now we saw that it is for 1 meter cube. Now for 2.5 meter cube of construction of brickwork, what we do is we just multiply the value corresponding to 1:4 mortar, which is 1.75 cement bags into 2.5, which is 4.38 bags of cement. And for the sand, which is 0.25 cubic meters, we multiply it by 2.5, and this is because we need 2.5 cubic meters of, the requirement is 2.5 cubic meters of brickwork. So we multiply it by 2.5 and we get 0.625 meter cube of sand. Similarly, we saw that we needed 500 bricks for the 1:4 proportion. 500 bricks were is what we get from the table. And since it is 2.5 times the work, we multiply 500 by 2.5. And so we get the value of 1250 bricks. So with this, we come to the conclusion of today's video lesson. In today's video lesson, we learned about the method and procedure to prepare estimation for simple projects using schedule of rates and engineering data. We also learned how to calculate the quantities required in a building project. We saw how to calculate the quantity of cement that is required, the concrete, the sand, that, sand and aggregate that is required in the concrete mix. How much of bricks are needed when we have the specification of the mortar ratio. So these are some of the concepts that we learned in today's lesson.